But when you preach the gospel of healing, of deliverance, of setting free, that Jesus, the Son of God, came to set us free, I tell you, you will see people seeking freedom, seeking deliverance, seeking a restoration with God. Over the years, I have been troubled by the gospel that we hear these days. And because of that, you find that a lot of people, now listen carefully to me tonight, please examine yourself on the gospel you are walking on. Because friends, it's no use going on a journey and you don't know where you're going. Amen? It's no use doing something and you don't know what you're doing. It's no use. What have I believed in? Do I believe in a God that changes lives? Do I believe in a God that heals? What gospel did I hear? When you understand that tonight, you can reach out for healing, for deliverance, for salvation, and for the blessing in your life. Friends, everywhere the gospel is preached, you will see two things. The power of God is manifested. And Jesus is exalted. Because it's the gospel of the kingdom. So friends, hallelujah. Thank you, brother. Hallelujah. The gospel of the kingdom has got the power to break men's hearts. The Bible said when the apostle was preaching, the men said they were cut to their heart. In other words, they had a conviction in their spirit. God convicted them. People are coming to churches and they're living their way without conviction. Because the gospel is not touching their life and bringing their sin out and asking them to commit themselves to Christ. So before we continue, let me ask you, what gospel have you believed in? What gospel have you embraced? I come to realize that there's a lot of gospel nowadays. The gospel of self-pleasure. Oh, you can have all the pleasure you want to have. There's a lot of people that live their life in pleasure. And they forget that God asks us to be disciplined and walk in holiness.